What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about schedules in Revit. More specifically, I'm going to be showing you all of the different types of schedules in Revit which we can create. I'm going to be talking about some of the specifics of each type, and so you can kind of pick out which one you want to use for your specific task. Now before we jump into Revit, I would like to take a moment to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses where I take the extra time to kind of go slowly, step by step, and explain all of these different topics inside of Revit. I've got over 130 hours of content, and for example, one of the courses is exactly on this topic, which is schedules inside of Revit. Now, apart from those courses, you can also find my customized Revit templates, so some ready-to-go Revit templates. You can find some really high-quality Revit families, and also there is a plugin available as well. Okay, now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. You can see here I've got this office building. This is actually a part of my office building course where I show you how to design this whole building and how to produce all of the project documentation for this specific building. So that's an interesting course that you can check out on my website as well. Okay, now for this building, let's create some schedules. So to create the first schedule, let's go here to the view menu, and then you can go here to create. So you can see here we have the create panel, and then here we have schedules. So the first schedule option, as you can see, is the schedule quantities. Then we have the graphical column schedule, then we have material takeoff, sheet list, note block, and view list. So these are all of the types. So we have these six types of schedules. Now you can create your schedules here, but also there's another way. You can go here to your project browser, find schedule quantities here, right click, and then you can see that you have all of those same schedules listed out here as well. So those are the two different approaches to creating a new schedule. I'm just going to go here to schedules, and let's start off with the first one, which is schedule quantities. This is kind of the main one, and the first thing you want to do with this schedule is pick out the category for this particular schedule. So for example, if you want to create a schedule for all of your, I don't know, you want to do it for curtain panels, well, you can just find here curtain panels, select that. You can give it a different name, so you can add dash, or I don't know, one, for example, and then you can click OK. So that's going to be the schedule name, and then you can pick out all of the parameters. So this is basically all of the parameters that are associated with those curtain panels. All of the parameters that are available with the curtain panels, well, those are going to be listed out here, and then you can just place them. So you can say, okay, I want the type, also I want to include the width, I want to include the height. If I have the width, makes sense to include the height. And then you can add something else as well, perhaps family or something. Okay, so once you have all of these listed out here, you can play around with the positioning by using these arrows. So you can move things up and down, kind of list them out in a way that you want. And then here we have some options for filtering, sorting and grouping, formatting and appearance. I'm not going to go kind of into all of this. As I said, I explained that in my course, but you have a lot of options to set up here. And then when you click OK, you're going to be creating that schedule. And here, as you can see, we have all of our panels that are available, and we have everything listed out here. So that's the first type of schedule, which is schedule quantities. Okay, let's now move forward. Let's go to the view menu. Let's go again to schedules. And now I'm just going to skip the graphical column schedule just because I want to cover the material takeoff first, because I think there's a lot of confusion between when to use the material takeoff and when to use the schedule quantities. So let's use the material takeoff now. Again, you're going to get a similar or pretty much the same dialogue here to pick out the material or to pick out the category. So let's go here with walls, for example. Then I'm going to click OK. And then again, you have an option to pick out your parameters, but now it's going to be a little bit different. So it's not only going to be all of the parameters that you have, but also you're going to have a lot of not only wall parameters, but also material parameters. So for example, material area, material as paint, material comments. So it's going to kind of bring in both the main family parameters, as well as all of the materials that are inside of that family, that are used for that family as well. So for example, it's going to give you things about the wall. So for example, family and type of the wall, you might want to have the length of the wall, but then we can also have the material name for the materials that are there on that wall. You can have material volume and so on and so forth. You can even have area, for example, if you want to add that. So if I create this schedule now, it's going to look like this. So as you can see, for each wall type, so for example, these are the walls that we have. This is exterior wall, 500 millimeter. Here, as you can see, this is just all of the same segments. So as you can see, it's the same length, but then it's kind of broken down to all of the materials that are in this wall segment. So we have one wall segment that's 747 centimeters, and then we have kind of a little field or a row for each of the materials. So we have air, we have gypsum wallboard, we have exterior insulation, we have concrete, and then we have some metal sheeting. And then we also have the volumes of each of those materials, and then we also have the material area. So if you want to calculate how much material goes into each of the independent walls, or in this case walls, but it can be any other family, then you would use the material takeoff schedule. The regular schedule quantities is not going to give you information on the materials. So depending on what the information is, you're going to pick out either one or the other. So it's just referring to the same elements, just the material takeoff one allows you to actually calculate the quantities of each individual material. Now this is really good because, for example, here you would just kind of calculate the amount of, for example, in this case, this is just the panels. So how many of each panel you have, but for this one, you can kind of separate that into materials. So how much concrete you need for this building site, how much exterior insulation you need, how much gypsum wallboard you need. So it's basically different things for different schedules for calculating different things. So that's basically the difference between those two. I would call these kind of the main two schedules that you're going to be using inside of Revit. Okay, now when we've covered that, let's now move forward and let's cover the rest. So now other schedule that we have here is the graphical column schedule. So this is a schedule that kind of graphically shows you all of the columns that you have in your model. So what you'll see here is you have a list of levels. So this is the minus underground, the street level, the ground level, and so on and so forth. For each of the levels, you have the level name, and then we have the elevation, and then we have the column locations. Now, this is basically referring to the grids. So this is on the intersection of grids A and 3. This is A and 4, B and 3, B and 4, and so on. So it's just going to give you all of the columns that you have there, so you can have kind of an easy graphical representation of those columns. For this particular schedule, you can add so much more here. So if you want to have a title of the schedule, you can say columns or something like that, and then it's going to have that name. You can set up some of the other options on how this little table is going to look like. So you can pretty much set everything up graphically just to make sure it looks exactly how you want it to look. Here we have the grid appearance, visibility graphics. You can set up the text appearance even. So just for the text, which text type is going to be used. So here, if I use this one, it's just going to make the columns darker, or this main title darker. So this is just how these schedules look, and it's just going to lay out all of your columns. So it's pretty basic, pretty straightforward, and this is only going to be used for, obviously, for columns. Okay, now moving forward, let's cover the next one, which is going to be a sheet list. Now this is a really cool schedule because it's going to kind of help you out to kind of handle your sheets. So in this case, let's see, we only have one sheet, so let's create a new one. So let's create a new sheet. So for this one, we can perhaps, let's place that graphical columns schedule there, and we can also place a section there as well, just to make it a little bit interesting. I'm not going to be perfectly kind of aligned here. And then let's create another one as well. So a new sheet, A1. And then there we can place an elevation. I don't know, something like that. There we go. Okay, so once we have a few of these sheets created, now I can go here to schedules, and then I can go to sheet list. And then for the sheets, again, here it's going to skip that first step where you pick out the category, and it's immediately going to go to your sheets category. And then here you have all of the parameters that are associated with sheets. So you have approved by, assembly code, so these are all for the assemblies if you have those. Then we have checked by, the current revision date, current revision description, and so on, designed by, drawn by, and then we have the sheet number, for example, and the sheet name, and then I can add the drawn by and designed by and checked by. Okay. So once you have all of these filled out, when you click OK, it's going to generate that schedule. And as you can see, it's going to look like this. So it's just an easy way of kind of keeping track of all of your sheets. Now, in this case, it doesn't make too much sense because we only have three sheets. But imagine if you had like hundreds of them, as you usually do on real life complex projects. Well, in that case, this would be crucial. Also here, just because this isn't filled out, you can actually just click in here and then you can fill out all of this important information, which is cool as well. Okay, moving forward, let's go back to the View tab and let's go here to Schedules, and then we have the Note Block Schedule. Now, the Note Block Schedule, I actually have a video on that they've released recently on how to use this. But basically, you create a note family, and I explained that in that video. So I'm just going to link it up in the cards above so you can check that video out. But anyways, in that video, I show you how to create this note family. And then here you can add numbers and text, in this case, for those notes. And then you can create a schedule. Now, in this case, the schedule is empty because we don't have any notes. But let me just show you real quick here. Let's open up a section. And then let's say I want to add a note here. So I can go to annotate. I can go to symbols. So these notes are designed as symbols. So you just click here. This is note one. And then I can add a leader. And then I can say, OK, point to here. And then I can say, okay, select that. And here I can add my note. So I can say, check this and click apply. Okay, and let's just add one more. So place it here. Note two, and then I can say, here for the text, let's say larger door. Apply. Oops, I have to hit enter. Apply. Okay, did it write it? No. Okay, now it did. Let's see, did it do it for the other one correctly? If you don't hit enter, it's not going to fill it out. Yeah. I keep forgetting that sometimes. Okay, here we go. And now if I go to my note block schedule, as you can see, it's just going to give me those notes and the text in the notes. So it's a really cool way of having all of your notes inside of a schedule. So instead of having actual text on your sheets, which usually wouldn't be good because you might have too much text and it might not look good, this is a really cool and clean way of handling these. So I really like that option. And then also you have this option to highlight in the model. So it's just going to bring you to that. It's just going to bring you to the position of that note. So it's really easy to find. Like you see this, okay, but where is that? Just click highlight on model and it's going to bring that up, which is really cool. So there you go. That's the note block schedule. And as you said, check out that video if you want to see how to create those little families that I used. Okay, moving forward, let's go to view schedules. And then the final one is the view list, which is kind of similar to the sheet list. So when we open that up again, we kind of skip the first step of picking out the category because the category is views. And then you just have all of the all of the properties for those views. So for example, you want a scale value, you want a view name, you want a view type, and so on. And then let's bring this up, and then it's just going to give you a schedule list or a schedule view of all of the views, which is also really good. Kind of keep track of what's going on and how many views you have, especially on larger. So this, I wouldn't consider this a large project just because it's a kind of an exercise. So in real life, just imagine this times at least 10. So you can understand how useful it is to have this as kind of as a schedule view. And there you go. So those are all of the main schedule types. So I hope you kind of have a better understanding of what each of these is for and how to create them. As I said, I have the entire course on schedules, which you can check out on my website. And if you want to get access to this building model or any of my other Revit project files, you can find those on my Patreon page, which I'm going to include in the description of this video. So link to my Patreon page and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.